So hi, everyone. Thanks for coming to this presentation at Embedded World. I'm delighted to be with all of you this morning. We're here to speak about security. The point is, security is at the core of any connected device. How can we address security? How can we do it the right way? That's the point. Just like any silicon vendor, we have some ideas about the way to do this. We have some ideas coming from our legacy business in smart card that we call now Secure Element. But how to address it properly for IoT business, knowing that the constraints are different? We have a huge panel of customers. Whether from any, if you discuss with any silicon vendor, they will tell that we don't know all our customers. We have tens of thousands of customers doing multiple applications, different segments. We call it general purpose business, but it can be around automotive, it can be around consumer, it can be around industrial, and so on. So compared to the original security business that was pushed by the secure element business around payment cards, ID, and so on, this is something really different. So how to solve this conundrum? That's why we come with a solution which is based on silicon, because this is our DNA. We speak about silicon devices, and we address this need, this requirement, because we know that regulation is coming. Today, we see the increasing number of devices. With a rising number of devices connected to some back-end services, cloud services, whether from the GAFA or even private cloud as well, how do we address this security conundrum? That's the point of my presentation. And we think that the appropriate answer is to go through a silicon root of trust. That's what I'm going to introduce here. So I will say a brief word about STMicro and STM32. This is, at some point, a commercial presentation, but I will go fast on this aspect, just to stress the importance of the security root of trust. That is very important. And how do we address this? And what it is enabled in the end? Because having a root of trust is one thing. OK, we answer the question of security, but can it be as well an enabler to additional security things, including services, provisioning, all that stuff that's coming on the top of the original silicon device? So about ST. ST is one of the largest microcontroller vendors. Last year was pretty good. We reached up to $60 billion of revenue. So the business is booming. We are happy about this. We have around 1,400,000 employees around the world. We address multiple markets with multiple manufacturing sites. ST is back to the, at some point, back to the original IDM model, with increasing the capacity of manufacturing in Europe and all around the world. That is something that is quite strategic these days. And we are focused on CSR constraints, meeting some global standards. Regarding the product, just like you've seen in the previous presentation, we address multiple markets. This one is the original world map and product portfolio, I would say, at some point. So here, we have some low-end products with addressing ultra-low power, addressing mainstream MPUs, mainstream MCUs, with low-end, high-end, and mid-end as well. We have as well some wireless MCUs addressing Bluetooth, ZigBee, and all the classic wireless protocol. And what is interesting here is that for any new product we place on the market, we target two silicon security standards, which is PSA certified. It was promoted and pushed by Arm a couple of years ago. Now it's in place. And next to that, we have CZIP, which covers more or less the same thing. It brings more flexibility. And CZIP is promoted by a consortium of industrial companies with the focus of having something robust in terms of silicon covering some security function. I will go through this in a couple of minutes. So this is a wide product portfolio covering all the different segments you can find, where you can find MCUs, in fact. So regarding IoT security, that is something that is important and that we need to address. One thing which is of importance at ST, on a yearly basis, we ask customers to come at a special event. We ask them about the expectation in terms of performance, in terms of features, and in terms of security. all of them want to introduce some sort of security in their product, but they don't really know how. They don't have the expertise. Security is quite complex. It has an impact on performance. It has an impact on the life cycle. So it's quite complex to integrate. So at some point, companies like 60 have to come with an answer. Beyond this, beyond the technical aspect, there's the issue of regulation. I would say that today there has been some progress, but regarding security evaluation and certification, the ecosystem is still much fragmented. So why should I cover one specific security standard? Why there are other standards? In the end, how can I put my product on multiple markets with one security certification framework? Today, that's the real issue. It is driven by private sector and public regulation, so it's not aligned as of today. We need some global recognition because today products are global. They need to address all the market and all the places around the world. So how to address everything, every places in one shot. And beyond this, there's a question of national sovereignty. Governments and nations, through their national agencies, they want some sort of security standard. They have some expectations. So how to address this? How to tackle this? This is not simple, but we think that let's go to the bottom, to the root of the problem. We think that we can do this thanks to a foundational approach with a minimum set of security function and a sort of strategy with one thing that we call scale up. What I do on one product, I can do this on multiple products. What I do on one MCU for my product portfolio, I would have the same approach for the other MCUs covering different business with more performance and so on. So having one unified approach in order to scale up, doing some reuse. This term comes from the original smart card business. When you certify the silicon device, you have the possibility to do the certification of the operating system without re-evaluating the silicon device. So that's what we call reuse, and the right word is composition. And the last thing is about mapping, starting from the security function that are covered by the silicon device. Some of them can be reused to cover the security function of the OEM device, meaning that there are some synergies between what can be done at the silicon device and what can be done at the OEM device level. That is very important. So we have some sort of scaling here thanks to what we can do around the silicon root of trust. So what we propose at ST, we propose a sort of framework. I would say it's a high-level framework that covers some classic security function. I think about the secure boot, the secure update, the secure storage. So in any device, we have some cryptography function, but cryptography in itself is fine. We have established and proven algorithm for many years, but the key issue is how do we protect keys? That is the key problem today around cryptography. So what we need to implement is sort of secure storage to protect keys properly, thanks to security measures, thanks to specific APIs. Then we have additional security function, including device authentication. When I connect a device to the cloud, to the internet, how can I prove that it is a genuine device? How can the vendor on the cloud side can be sure that it's not a fake device? That is something really important. Next to that, we have what we call about software IP protection. I will go back to this sort of thing. It's about protecting customer firmware, but protecting as well some third-party components that may come from additional vendors, focusing on AI or other very specific functions. Then beyond this, you have secure manufacturing, application lifecycle. We speak about commissioning the device, bringing some certificate, bringing some credential, and then how to decommission the device when it has reached its end of life. So all of this is quite important. At ST, we have defined some sort of meta framework covering all these functions just to explain how to focus on what is really important, in fact, in terms of security for connected device. So it's a sort of streamlined security framework. The goal is to protect customer assets during product lifetime. We cover this thanks to a set of security functions that you find here on this circle. And how can we prove that these security functions are properly covered? This is done thanks to security validation, thanks to security assurance. Starting from the STM32 Trust Framework, we have boiled it down to two security certification programs who are very important today for silicon devices and that have the value of existing. And at ST, this is a strong strategy around security. We cover two standards. The beauty of this is that we do one single evaluation with certified and accredited laboratories. And we can, in one evaluation, we can cover the two standards. First of them is PSA certified. A couple of years ago, ARM introduced the platform security architecture for connected devices. It is based on the ARM architecture, but at that time there was nothing. So they brought their technology, they brought some specification, they brought the architecture of the root of trust, and thanks to that, you have the possibility to develop an application in a secure way on top of this PSA architecture. The second one is CZIP. CZIP stands for Security Evaluation Standard for IoT Platform. This standard was initiated by one silicon vendor a couple of years ago. It is now accepted by the whole industry. And compared to ARM PSA, it has more flexibility. That means that thanks to CZIP, we can cover entry-level devices that don't feature physical isolation through the ARM trust zone. So that's interesting. That means that even with entry-level cores, just like some RISC-V or Cortex-M0, Cortex-M5, we can claim a strong level, a high level of robustness for silicon devices. What's behind this, in fact? It's quite complex, but what's behind this is a set of security functions. I would say that is the baseline for IoT platform security certification. We speak about identification, attestation of the device. We speak about secure communication. How do we guarantee that the device communicates securely with another device on the PCB, in the application? It can be connecting with a radio device, connecting with a sensor. And how do we guarantee that the product lifecycle is protected, that we cover all these devices, all these states properly without any security breach? We speak about factory reset of the platform, secure install of applications, secure install of the root of trust, this sort of thing. The beauty of this is thanks to the security evaluation and certification program, you don't have to take care of this. This is taken in charge by ST thanks to our team of engineers. They develop the silicon device plus the embedded software that meets this security function. This is the first set of security function. We have another one that is of interest as well. We speak about this list comes from CZIP, in fact. We speak about the robustness of the device. Depending on the target of evaluation, depending on the security level that is expected, we can define the risk. We can define the type of attack that may be under analysis. Depending on the risk, we can limit to software attacks, meaning the device is considered as safe. And all the attacks will come from attacker connecting through the communication channel, through USB, through UART, through SPI, any kind, or even radio. We have this model. But beyond this, we consider physical attack. And we have put in place some security measures to bring some physical attack resistance. This is more or less what has been introduced in smart card 20 years ago. And we consider that today it is important to have some robustness against what we call side channel analysis. Meaning people trying to monitor what's happening inside the chip thanks to the electromagnetic emission or the power consumption by putting a small resistor on the power supply. So today, we claim this sort of feature as well because we consider that for products that will be on the market for, let's say, 10, 15, or 20 years, we have to take this risk into account right now. Beyond this, we speak about additional function, about compliance with additional standards and so on. And all of things managed by ST. So as an application vendor, they need to focus on this because it's already managed by the silicon vendor. So if we go, if we now read down to the root of trust, there are three key messages here. First, we can deliver a robust and proven root of trust, which is a cornerstone of an IoT device. Thanks to this standardized certification, evaluation and certification approach with PSA certified and global platform CZIP, thanks to a list of security functions that I briefly described on the previous slide. So this is the first point. The second point is this root of trust that has been tested is the entry point to additional security certification at the device level. There's still much fragmentation here, but thanks to this root of trust, we think that depending on the segment, depending on the evolution of the regulatory environment, we can cover many of them. We speak about some private schemes. Here we speak about UL 2900. On the right, you have CSA Matter that has developed its own security certification framework for radio devices. We speak about EN 303645 for METSI, which is quite popular now. And there are works today between CZIP and ETSI to do some mapping, something which is how do you do a sort of equivalence between the various schemes in order to speed up the certification of the UM device. For industrial application, people work on a mapping with IEC62443, which is very important as well. And beyond this, in the US, there's IOXT. And what is very important on the left part of the slide, there's the European and US IoT regulation that is coming. You may have heard about Radio Equipment Directive, RED. You may have heard about Cybersecurity Resilience Act. It's coming. Today, it's not in place. But if we think about applications that will be on the market in 4, 5, or 10 years from now, we need to take all this into account. So this is the second point. And the third point, because here I spoke much about constraints. It's hard. We have to integrate security. We need a robust root of trust. We need to be compliant with some standard. But beyond this, what we need to think is that there can be value. Beyond being protected, there can be value because we consider that having a robust root of trust can be an enabler for additional security services. Some are legacy services. I speak about Secure Boot and Secure Firmware Update, which is something commonplace today for any IoT device. But beyond this, we can deliver services around secure storage, device attestation, and what is pushed by ST, and I invite you to come on our booth because we have 5 demos around this new service. We think about introducing some third-party software, meaning that one vendor can develop its own software and then license some additional software coming from AI vendors, coming for people expert in motor control. They have the possibility to license this software, have it integrated in their application without attacking at some point this, without having access to this third-party component, meaning that we can deliver some sort of business model around this, and that is the beauty of the thing, that we can have multiple vendors having different software, and every part is protected from the others, so there's no issue with security, no issue with copyright, and this can be done thanks to this new type of services. So that is the beauty, that is the interesting thing that that is brought by this new service. I will go back to it later on. So I spoke about security thanks to PSA Certify and CZIP. At ST, we have a strategy is that for any new device we place on the market, we consider that it has to meet a level 3, which is today quite demanding for the IoT market. So we claim CZIP level 3 and PSA certifies level 3, including physical attack resistance. That is something that's important because we will cover side channel resistance for any new device. Here we have 3 different classes of product. On the left part, that's what we consider legacy product, even if today we sold it by millions. But from the security standpoint, we call them legacy, but it's not legacy at all at some point. We claim level 1, meaning a sort of security level which is declaration about the security function that have been implementing in the product. There's no pen testing, no code review, so that's the entry level. It's aligned with PSA level 1 and CZIP level 1 at some point. even if the zip level one is a bit different. So in this category, you will find some existing ST product. We speak about high performance STM32H7, G0, G4 for mixed signal application. This one is in place. Next group, next category is level three with open source software. The first of them that was introduced quite 2 years ago is the STM32U5. It's an entry-level product with ultra-low power performance, with Cortex-MTEC-3, physical attack resistance, and physical isolation. In this profile, we have a robust root of trust with open source software. Here it revolves around ARM TFM. That is an interesting component because it delivers services. TFM support secure storage, crypto, attestation. You have all these services that comes on top of the silicon device. And when ST does the evaluation, asks for the evaluation and certification of the device, in the scope of evaluation, you have the silicon device plus the ARM TFM. So here, U5 is certified. MP135 fall into this category as well. This one is a zip level 3. There's no TFM because it's an MPU. And then we have WBA. Then we come to the third category, which is STM32H5. In this category, there's no more TFM, even if TFM is supported. We introduce what we call the Secure Manager that covers the same specification as ARM PSA TFM. But beyond this, we introduce what I just mentioned, which is the Secure Manager with the possibility to have some third-party software component directly supported by the root of trust. So this is a comprehensive solution that is developed, supported, and maintained by ST. So it's a sort of one-stop shop solution. Any developer can take the device plus the software and have something robust, and we're just focusing on the application that is on the non-secure part, querying services to the secure manager that is PSA compliant in terms of API. So once again, what are the key takeaways here? There are three of them. Once again, the root of trust is at the heart of OM IoT device security. So three important things. First of all, is having a robust and proven, meaning certified root of trust, gives evidences and build trust to the final customer. To go through this, we are going to introduce a program with logos, with white papers, all that stuff, just to explain that what is considered as robust is really robust and has been tested by an independent laboratory. It covers the silicon device, some embedded secure software, in line with a set of security functions. I spoke about secure boot, secure firmware update, or all the security functions that are necessary to a secure IoT device. The second one is the way to ease the path to security certification as the OEM level. I spoke about 62443. I spoke about IUXT, Matter, all these security standards that are now many on the market and that can be addressed easily and accelerated thanks to the security root of trust. And the first point is opening the door to third parties and additional services. It can come from additional vendors. Here, on this part, we work with Amazon, with Microsoft, with Kudelski. If you come to our booth, you can see all the demos. We offer cloud connectivity thanks to a specific additional application in the secure area that takes in charge the management of the credential independently for the OEM application. So we have a clear segregation here between the various components, and we guarantee the security of each subcomponent. So that was really interesting here. And I invite you to come, and we have a follow-up discussion if you have some questions, and if you want to go further around this, these 3 points, and if basically you have an interest in this. So thank you very much. If you have some questions, just let me know, and I still have 2 minutes left for this. Thank you.